my breath. Scared to rock the boat and make a mess.
For countless hours, they've trained, quietly striving to join their heroes.
The women who got inspired by the show have been working their butts off and have gotten so good.
Hear my voice, hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground.
I'm really excited to see this new wave of ninja women that are coming out and just doing awesome.
Then, on a magical night in Philadelphia, their efforts were rewarded.
I got the eye of the tiger.
Wow. Oh. Great agility. Look at the power there. Four women are in the top 30 for the first time ever.
It's so amazing that four girls got to make the top 30. Goes to show that we can compete with the best of them.
Oh, you see that thing rumbling? She's about to pull it down.
To be part of this historical moment has been beyond what I could have imagined.
These women are tearing it up.
Tonight, the Fantastic Four continue their journey.
We all can challenge each other and help each other get better.
Oh, she's got it!
All four of us are absolutely going to hit that buzzer tonight.
Cryo! Oh! Incredible effort!
I'm going to go all the way.
Welcome to the Philadelphia City Finals. We're outside the 100-year-old Richmond Power Plant. It's our last stop before next week's national finals in Las Vegas. Hello, everyone. I'm Matt Eisman, alongside my partner, former NFL defensive end, Akbar Bajabiamila. Now, Philly is known, of course, for the beloved hero of the silver screen, Rocky Balboa. But tonight, we have another inspirational story in the making. Among the 30 athletes competing, a record-setting four female competitors.
Wow. Yo, Adrian! We've got one of the top winning competitors of all time, Michelle Gorgi.
Yes, she's done it!
Plus three female rookies.
Polsky rockets through!
All looking to make history.
She's making it look easy.
If they can earn a ticket to Vegas tonight.
Look at the power and flex, LeBrack.
But it's not just the women. We've got the weatherman, Joe Morovsky.
He is flying.
And Philly's hometown hero for qualifying, Najee Richardson.
Yeah!
Plus the very first American Ninja Warrior, Jeff Britton.
Jeff Britton did it. This Philly course was brutal in qualifying, and now four more obstacles have been added. For more on the course, let's go down to Christine Leahy.
Thanks, Matt and Akbar. First, just like in qualifying, the ninjas will have to make it past the floating steps, the log grip, paddle boards, the wall drop, rolling thunder, and the 14.5-foot warped wall. Then onto the four obstacles added for the finals. As always, this back part of the course starts with the salmon ladder, where athletes have to jump the metal bar up four rungs. Next is the flying shelf grab, where competitors have to swing from a bar, catch themselves on a small shelf, then swing to a second shelf, and finally leap to safety. On the all-new stair hopper, athletes will propel a bar down and then up the metal staircase using whatever is left of their upper body strength. Finally, competitors will face the brutal invisible ladder. They'll have to pump their arms upward like they're climbing a ladder and ascend the 30-foot chute. If they make it to the top and complete all 10 obstacles, they're headed to the national finals in Las Vegas. Guys?
To see how these obstacles were developed, check out the NBC digital exclusive Crashing the Course at facebook.com/NBC Ninja Warrior. Well, it's going to be a big night for the ladies, so we're going to start it off with the first of our four women who qualified for the finals. This is Massachusetts school teacher Alyssa Beard. Tonight, she's part of the Fantastic Four, but in class, she's just Ms. Beard.
Everyone has their science books out.
I'm a fifth grade teacher in Middleborough, Massachusetts. I love everything about it.
And 4 times 5 is 20.
Being a teacher is a lot like everything I'm doing athletically. There's no end to the whole journey. There's always improvement. There's always ways to become better.
Four women are in the top 30 for the first time ever.
Being able to be part of this historical moment where four females qualify to finals has been just so beyond what I could have imagined. I hope to show students by competing on American Ninja Warrior that if you set your mind to something and you really work towards it,
My fifth grade teacher couldn't do that.
You can accomplish anything you want to.
There's Alyssa's family back to cheer her on, along with Michelle Warnke, Rachel Goldstein, and Jesse LeBrec. All of them will be running a little bit later.
Well, she's got to be the most popular teacher in her school, Matt.
She was just a revelation in qualifying. Only been training Ninja Warrior obstacles for about a year, but a natural. Started winning competitions at local ninja gyms, sent in a submission tape, and now she could be going to Vegas. And there's Jesse Graff. All these women want to do what she did, earn a ticket to the national finals. But now the law, Gret, never a gimme. Ooh, almost came off there. Here, just 5'4", 125 pounds, now facing the paddleboards.
I want to see Alyssa Beard go for broke here.
Oh, a good save. And she's moving on to the wall. And for this obstacle, you have to climb to the top of the wall, then jump down to that trampoline.
Showing that upper body strength.
I see you, Miss Beard.
Let's see if the teacher remembers how to handle this obstacle. She's got to drop 11 feet to the trampoline and bounce up to catch one of those pipes. Great transition.
Miss Beard.
Wow. Now has to get to the platform. And she's going to slide down to the bottom where she can generate more swing. But she's struggling. Miss Beard spinning
right into her abs right there. Come on, Miss Beard.
Ooh, oh,
Superman that. Superwoman that. There you go.
This ain't recess.
Inch it back. Put your back into it.
And Miss Beard is moving on. And this crowd's so supportive, but she spent a lot of energy on that wall drop, and that's going to make this next obstacle, Rolling Thunder, even more difficult. This took her out in qualifying. Has to jump up to that heavy metal wheel and roll it end over end across the 22-foot track. No woman was able to defeat this obstacle in qualifying. Can she do it here in the finals?
No, she better do it in the finals. I got a question for you, Ms. Beard. Do you have enough heart here to push it all the way through?
Well, look at her going. Show and tell time. Look at that. You can see that plexiglass. We've added an extra pane for the finals. Just makes it even harder because they have to reach around those sections.
Come on, Miss Beard.
Miss Beard.
It's not recess time yet.
Finding the determination.
No time to play now. Keep it moving.
The crowd on their feet.
Boy, she's taking that action right there. Uh-oh.
What does she have left?
Come on, girl.
And she's still moving the wheel.
Come on. I got a question for you. I got a question for you, Miss Beard. Come on
now. And you can see that wheel moving. It's so complex.
Oh!
Alyssa Beard splashing down on Rolling Thunder. But the entire crowd on their feet, inspired by the effort of the fifth grade teacher.
Well, let me tell you, Alyssa Beard just would not quit. She battled the wall drop for almost 40 seconds before finally hooking her legs and pulling herself up, and then fought her way across Rolling Thunder. But look at that face. She had nothing left, and the arms gave out.
I just got pumped out. Had a long hold on the logs. Really did me in.
Up next, he's only 5'2", but they call him the Big C. This is New York liquor store owner Carl Fantuzzo. He's a 42-year-old father of two, but when his kids grew up, he got a new hobby, Ninja Warrior.
Both my boys now are in college. My wife and I are empty nesters. That's an adjustment. No baseball games, no football games to run to, and no kids to drive around. We have dinner now, and then we stare at each other, wondering what we're gonna do. Some people go through a midlife crisis. Because of Ninja Warrior, I decided that it was a great opportunity for me to ramp up my training.
He told me he was gonna change the basement around to be a workout area for American Ninja Warrior. Whenever he puts his mind to something, he gives it 110%. Yeah!
With no kids to look after at home anymore, I've been able to travel to ninja gyms and competitions all over the country.
I feel more experienced. I feel ready to make it to Vegas.
And there's his wife, Christine, and their two sons. Also a huge group of supporters out here from Rochester. Well, Fantuzzo fell on Rolling Thunder in qualifying, and tonight he wants to get past it so he can face the Warp Wall. He's had Warp Wall nightmares since he failed there 2 years ago.
Yeah, he's got the eye of the tiger. He's been going to ninja competitions all over the country the past couple of years to get ready. He wants that wall bad.
Now the log grip, and at 5'2", not easy to get a grip. But no problem for Big C. Now facing the very dangerous paddle boards, which took out a third of the competitors in qualifying. But he's through.
I see you. He is light on his feet for a 42-year-old. And look at him. Why is he so cut?
Reaching up to start the wall drop, Fantuzzo only 130 solid pounds on that 5'2 frame.
And he's got the upper body to climb up. But with his size, I worry about this trampoline drop.
But a perfect transition right onto the pipe. Has to get on that platform.
Look at that tippy toes.
Crawl back.
Using every inch of that 5'2 frame.
And Carl Fantuzzo, so popular out here. He's getting closer to that warp wall, but a big roadblock in front of him right now. Rolling Thunder. This is the obstacle that took him out in qualifying. That run, he made it about halfway across the track before his arms just gave out.
Well, Matt, he's almost halfway across already.
Shoot, looks like the Rolling Thunder is moving him. It's like he's caught up in the rain cloud here, in the thunder cloud.
You can see just the effort. And that's the problem. Those spokes, they want to lock it in place. You have to fight for every inch of ground.
That boy is moving lightning fast on the Rolling Thunder. That's it. Man, look at that.
Carl Fantuzzo with his sons cheering him on.
I'm an empty nester.
Three more for the win.
Looking for that dismount. And you can see the wheel still sliding, though. Oh, he's got it. And now here it is, the obstacle that's haunted him, the warp wall. Can the 5'2" Fantuzzo get up this new 14.5-foot wall? There you go, Big C.
Fantuzzo is hungry. He wants this so bad.
You're not done. 2 years ago, he couldn't get to the top, but tonight, sweet redemption for Carl Fantuzzo, and he seals it with a kiss.
Man, let me tell you, that's impressive when you're 5'2", but that's even more impressive when you're 42 years old.
Everyone knew what this meant to him, but now it's the brutal back half of the course, starting with the salmon ladder.
This is the first time he's seen the salmon ladder in competition.
Has to go up four rungs.
Now keep the technique. Yeah, back muscles, triceps, biceps, nice.
Fantuzzo, he's done it, completed the salmon ladder. Now he'll be the first to try the flying shelf grab. Has to swing to that small ledge.
Couldn't complete it.
But still a victory to get to the eighth obstacle. We'll have to wait and see if that's far enough to get him to Vegas.
Well, it was a big moment for the 5'2 Fantuzzo to get up the wall. And at the flying shelf grab, he got his hands on the 2-inch ledge, but with tired arms, he couldn't hang on.
Ran out of gas, but I'm so happy. Finally beat that warp wall. It's been haunting me since season 6. Finally got it. Hopefully I did enough. See you in Vegas.
Here's what's coming up tonight. Only 3 women in history have earned a ticket to the national finals.
That's right, ladies. Woo!
Tonight, one of these 3 women hopes to join the club.
Absolutely gonna hit that buzzer tonight.
Plus, he's hit the buzzer 7 times in a row, including the one on stage 4 in Vegas.
Stage 4. Woo!
Can Jeff Britton keep his streak alive tonight?
Is that possible? Stay tuned.
When American Ninja Warrior returns. Welcome back American Ninja Warrior in Philadelphia. While we were away, three more athletes took on this city finals course. 57-year-old Miles Avery was trying to become the oldest athlete ever to qualify for Vegas.
He just keeps ticking. He's like the Energizer Bunny.
But the former U.S. Olympic gymnastics coach couldn't stick the landing at the wall drop. Couldn't lock onto the log. 42-year-old Greg Fleming, a three-time veteran, was making his first trip to the city finals.
There's a drop and a big bounce.
But the physical therapist from Delaware ran out of gas at Rolling Thunder. Marine Corps reservist Eric Torres battled his way across Rolling Thunder.
He's ad-libbing, and that's okay.
You got this, Eric!
But the man who climbs radio towers for a living couldn't climb the warp wall. Eric Torres comes up short. Well, our city finals course is always difficult, but our next athlete may be able to slay this beast. This is Alex Delacqua, and he's a knight at Medieval Times Dinner Theater. He entertains crowds for a living, and he's ready for this noble quest.
I'm a knight of the realm from Fort Lee, New Jersey. I joust for a living. I'm trained in medieval combat. A lot of horseback riding, a lot of sword fighting. Ninja Warrior is a very similar field for me to come here and compete. A lot of the horseback riding and stunts that I do help me with body core, legs, a lot of it. From riding a horse to getting and jumping on the obstacles is the same group of muscles.
Bucked off his steed, but still alive!
I'm already a medieval warrior. So now I'm hoping to become a ninja warrior.
There's his girlfriend, Sabrina. She's here along with some of Alex's family and fellow performers.
Oh, it's party time. He's taking off the armor and the chain mail. He's ready to go.
It's easy to be distracted by the costume, but he's a legitimate athlete, made it to Rolling Thunder in qualifying. And now through the floating steps. We know he can ride a horse, but needs to ride down the log ramp.
Full body contact here. Nice.
Now the paddle boards, which he barely got through in qualifying. Wow, very nimble. Now he'll duel against the wall drop. This knight is moving quickly.
Man, all that jousting, you can see he's developed some arm muscles.
Delacqua, 5'10", 160 pounds, now facing this 11-foot drop to the trampoline.
Breathe, just breathe.
All right, here's a jump.
And nice. A good leap there.
Nice tackle there.
Holding onto the log. The jousting ninja doth joust and win against the wall drop. But now battling the obstacle that vanquished him in qualifying. And a good mount there onto the Rolling Thunder.
Remember, in qualifying, this obstacle just wore people out. It's a long way across the track, and you've got to have great upper body strength. So he's gonna have to use his agility and his speed here to turn this big old wheel.
This wheel weighs over 100 pounds, and it is not truly a wheel. When you look at those spokes, they end up leveling out. That wheel, you have to force every rotation there.
There's eight spokes up there, so that's a lot of movement for Delacqua.
This wheel wants to remain stationary, so it is
when I tell you, when you start to see the deadhead there,
come on, Delacqua.
You know, he is pumped up. You gotta fight through lactic acid. If you are a medieval knight, then fight through the lactic acid.
This is a dragon that you must slay.
Well, he's gonna get slayed here by the Rolling Thunder.
Well, he's a performer and he goes out in style. But these athletes better be ready because these obstacles are brutal. Tonight is gonna be a knockdown, drag out, bare knuckle brawl in Philadelphia with this course, Akbar.
You can say all of that again because you're right. Delacqua started strong. But Rolling Thunder just wears you out. It's more like something you'd see on stage 3 in Vegas, and 10 feet in, he was gassed out.
Just gotta train a little bit harder next time, so maybe next year, you know?
Well, this course in Philly is a heavyweight fighter, but we're going to see some of our top ninjas, including the weatherman, Joe Moravsky. He'll run in a bit. Plus, it's ladies' night in Philly. There they are, the Fantastic Four. They made history by getting here. Now they want to shock the world again.
I'm just, like, excited to be a part of all of it.
That's coming up on American Ninja Warrior. Welcome back to the Philadelphia City Finals. While we were away, three more athletes attempted to make their way to the National Finals. Pennsylvania's John Gowder Jr. made it to Rolling Thunder in qualifying. But tonight, the industrial electrician had a power outage at the paddleboards.
Oh! Oh, he shockingly goes down!
Virginia EMT Yancy Quezada dressed like he was on vacation. Quezada can do! But his trip was cut short at the salmon ladder.
Boom shakalaka!
Marshall University's Tyler Cravens made it to the finals as a walk-on.
He looked real solid there.
But the exercise science major flunked his test at the wall drop.
Oh, bad science.
Well, we get ninjas from all occupations in all 50 states. Our next athlete is a barber from Pawtucket, Rhode Island. This is Fabio Figueredo, calls himself the Barber Ninja, and he wants to make the cut for Vegas.
The real benefit of barbering is not really cutting hair, it's the relationships. You can talk about your girlfriend, you can talk about your job. No, I'm a therapist. I make them look better physically and feel better mentally.
Have you spoken to her about that? That's key.
Cutting hair is actually a great equivalent to American Ninja Warrior. You want to deliver on the first try. There is no second chances. You mess up, you don't execute on point, it's over. I've been working really hard for this, and I want the world to watch this. Get your popcorn ready, because I'm going to Vegas, no problem.
And there's a look at a group of Fabio's friends and clients all making the trip from Rhode Island. Figueredo, one of the 21 athletes competing tonight who were knocked out in qualifying by Rolling Thunder. And this finals course is even tougher. And he is struggling here on the rope.
Well, this is not the place where you want to waste your energy.
Finally gets through, now heads for the log grip.
And the barber's one of the bigger guys out here, 6 feet tall, 180 pounds. Push that weight. Now he's getting going.
Trying to make up some time now on the paddleboards. A stumble on the paddleboards.
Man, this is so sloppy so far for Fabio, but he is fired up.
Now jumps right up to start the wall drop. Figueredo was a high school football and basketball player back in Rhode Island, but now runs a lot of obstacle course races.
But we've seen this trampoline take out some good athletes.
You need to be precise.
All right, here it is. Hit it.
Oh!
Oh! What? That's it! That's it! I don't know how he was able to escape.
Took a log to the face, but survived and rolls
wow,
through.
Man.
Somehow he survives, but this barber has had a number of close shaves already. Now it's the obstacle that knocked him out in qualifying, Rolling Thunder. He's a little taller than the other competitors, and those longer arms may help here.
Look at Fabio going here. This is where that upper body strength is going to come into play here.
The Rolling Thunder, we've added more plexiglass barriers. It is a real challenge. This barber, though, we know he's good with his fingers.
Yeah, and this ultimately takes you out of rhythm here. With the more plexiglass here, that throws your rhythm off here. A little different than what we saw in qualifying.
But he stopped his momentum. Now trying to switch around and go head first.
He's got it!
But he is looking gassed, Akbar.
Is he thinking what I'm thinking?
Push that!
Going for the dismount here, Akbar, but...
Oh, no!
The Barber Ninja gets cut by Rolling Thunder.
Man, the barber barely survived the paddle boards and took a log to the face at the wall drop. But at Rolling Thunder, once he stopped and looked around, he could never get it going again, and the arms gave out.
Oh, I had the momentum going and I stopped.
And when I stopped, my muscles stopped. I had the momentum. I should have just kept going and then jumped.
Well, Akbar, this may be the toughest city finals course we've ever had.
Philadelphia, man, you talk about the city of brotherly love. This course ain't got no love for anybody.
But this field in Philly is packed. Coming up, Jeff Britton, the first American Ninja Warrior. Joe Morawski.
Yes! Come for you!
Jamie Ron, Captain NBC, back where he belongs. And Chris Wilczewski.
Wow! Did you see that leak?
Some of the top ninja athletes take on Philly when American Ninja Warrior returns. Welcome back to Philadelphia, where it is ladies' night. Four women made it to tonight's city finals. Three have yet to run, including Rachel Goldstein and Jesse Flex Lebrecht. Our next competitor just turned old enough to compete. This is babyface 21-year-old Michael Torres. He's a carpenter from Minutola, New Jersey, and he's been building to this moment for years.
As a kid, you put anything in front of me, puzzle, Legos, I'm all over it. So when I came into high school, I found out they offered a woodshop program. I knew as a freshman it was exactly what I wanted to do with my life. So I graduated in 2013, and 3 months later, I was working.
Michael is a great thinker. He's able to compute and figure things out in his brain, specifically spatially.
Some people see a pile of wood, I see a table. Same thing with Ninja Warrior. I see the courses differently because I see how they're made. I get right in the shop and I build it. I train it over and over and over again until it's flawless. I've been training for American Ninja Warrior for about 3 years now, and I haven't missed a day since. I'm gonna go out there and just destroy it.
Well, his parents are watching at home, but Michael's cousins and other family members on the sidelines. Torres is our youngest competitor all season. Only made the 21-year-old age requirement by a few weeks.
Okay, young blood.
He's made the most of it. He had the fourth fastest finish in qualifying.
He's been a fan of the show since he was a kid, and now here he is competing and holding his own against greats like Jeff Britton, Joe Morawski, and Jamie Ron. Oh, got a little tangled up on the paddle boards, but he's moving on. Now the wall drop.
I can tell you, Torres was an all-around athlete in high school, played almost every sport, and was a state champion hurdler.
Now has to make this 11-foot drop onto the trampoline. Makes the grab. And gets past it with no problem.
Look at that face. He could pass for 16, but he is looking like a man on this course.
Now facing off against Rolling Thunder. The carpenter can use his upper body strength here.
Yeah, well, he's had the opportunity to build some of his own obstacles, but I can guarantee you he's never built this obstacle before. Look at that. His shirt says it all. It says he rolls deep, and he's rolling right now. Yeah, you see that? Look at that. He knocks to his feet and says, I've got this.
Well, Rolling Thunder weighs over 100 pounds. Torres 165, and he has just beasted his way through it.
Be careful on the dismount here. Nice. Nice, Torres.
Well, Michael Torres, the rookie, continues to roll deep into this city finals course.
Well, look at his shirt. He's got a picture of him climbing up the warp wall. It says Team Torres. Well, go ahead and put your stake at the top of this warp wall. Just like what's on his shirt. Says it on your shirt, doesn't it, Torres? Says it on your shirt.
Now the rookie faces the back half of this city finals course, starting with the salmon ladder. And he's on it.
Oh, boy, he slowed down a little. I think he's worn out from Rolling Thunder.
But we don't know what the cutoff will be yet, but probably going to have to get at least past the salmon ladder to get to Vegas. He reaches the top. And moving on to the flying shelf grab. No one's made it past this obstacle so far.
Let's
Taking his time for the first one. It's 6 feet.
Good job holding on to that first shelf. Now for the 8 foot lead.
Keep it narrow though here, Matt. His hands are getting wide here. That can be hard. Narrow, whoa! Wow.
There's more left in the tank for Torres.
And he is the first to get through the flying shelf grab.
Well, Matt, they say the youth is wasted on the young, but not this young one. Michael Torres is rolling.
Good job, Mike. Take your time. Check it out.
Now he'll be the first to try this new obstacle, the stair hopper. Another incredibly difficult upper body test. Has to hold on to the bar and jump it down the steps and then back up. This one, not just about strength or endurance, the precision.
Look at him going with the switch grip. Now, look, you only have about 4 inches on each side, so you have to be very precise here with moving it. A little too aggressive here, Matt, on the stair hopper. I'd like to see him take little tinier hops there, just like that.
Well, this leap up is the biggest challenge.
It's a big one. Watch out for the gap.
11 inches.
Woo! That boy, good!
What? Well, this run for the rookie continues. He's looking gassed. What does Torres have left?
His first year of eligibility.
No! Torres comes up short on the stair hopper, but the 21-year-old rookie just put up the best run of the night so far.
The stair hopper is tricky because there's nothing to hold the bar in place. Torres starts building up momentum to move forward, and the bar slides backwards, and he goes right off the rails.
She was gonna go for the dismount. Bad idea. Just messed up, that's all.
Some of our best are coming up, including Ryan Stratus. And to see Ryan's journey to Philadelphia, check out our digital series, 24 Before, available on the NBC app and at NBC.com.
Plus, in qualifying, they went farther than 75 men.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
How far can a record-breaking women get tonight? Rachel Goldstein runs next. Ago, we witnessed history. Michelle Warkey is back in the finals. One by one, they clinched their spots in the top 30. Flex LeBrec has made it. And when all was said and done, a record 4 women advanced to the city finals. Goldstein is in, and Alyssa Beard takes the final spot. 4 women moving on. Let's take a closer look at the Fantastic Four. 3 of the 4 are rookies, and they all point to 4-time veteran Michelle Warkey as one of their heroes. They're a diverse group made up of a 5th grade teacher, a caregiver, an occupational therapist, and a gym owner. And here comes the second member of the Fantastic Four to take a shot at the course. This is Rachel Goldstein from nearby Cherry Hill, New Jersey. She's got her fiancé Jeff on the sidelines. Those two just got engaged after 12 years together.
We were just hanging out on the beach at night, and he just popped the question. But I guess I was not surprised because it's been 12 years, but surprised because it's been 12 years. So.
12 years? What took you so long?
He's there alongside Jamie Ron, who trains with Rachel. Of course, the other women who qualified for tonight's finals will be watching as well. It really is remarkable that Goldstein is part of this history-making group of women as she started ninja training just a few months ago.
But she has a solid athletic background. You know, she was a competitive gymnast growing up and was a collegiate diver at Ithaca College.
Well, we've never had a rookie female earn a ticket to Vegas. Goldstein trying to be the first. She's on her way, getting through that first obstacle. Now the log grip. Goldstein only 5'4", 115 pounds. But she's through. Now squaring off against the paddleboards.
Look at, woo! Man, it's a good thing she's 5'4" there because she came very close to hitting the water there. Nice save, Goldstein.
She's been training since 2015. Her boyfriend moved to Cherry Hill, New Jersey, and just started training with Jamie Ron at Pinnacle Parkour. It's amazing how guys like Jamie Ron and Sam Sandin Wilcheski, they've introduced an entire new generation of athletes.
You can see Goldstein clearly has natural talent here, and now you couple that with the training that she's put together, this should be a very strong run.
Boom!
What
took
a return.
A little bump in the shoulders there.
That was a hard impact. She really got a good return on the trampoline. All and right. Look at that. Great control, rotating around the log.
And you see how she's using the other log, though, too, to get a little bit of momentum. She's got to slide down, though. Slide down a little further. You're 5'4", get down a little lower.
Well, that's the problem. The shorter you are, the lower down in the log you have to go to reach.
Yeah, that's it. Push back. Push back. Get that momentum and then try to lock
Oh! Rachel Goldstein, like the former college diver.
Like that?
Splashes down on the wall drop, but it just goes to show how challenging every obstacle is on this Philadelphia City Finals course.
Well, watch this. She gets a big bounce off the trampoline and hits hard up high on the pipe, but she just couldn't generate any swing to get over the landing pad, and eventually her grip gave out.
I just had no momentum and had a hard time gaining it.
Well, this course has been tough on everyone, women and men. Still had no finishers, but if anyone can break through, it may be our next athlete, Joe Marovsky. The Connecticut meteorologist has finished every city finals course he's ever faced. This would be his fourth straight tonight, if he can do it. Got his new baby, Emily, on the sidelines, along with his wife, Stephanie. And every ninja in the house will be watching this run, including Jeff Britton, Jamie Ron, and Ryan Stratus.
Joe Marovsky flying through the floating steps.
You can see him going for speed here. In fact, he told me, Matt, he's going for the fastest time tonight.
This course in Philly playing so difficult. Well, no one has completed this City Finals course, but Joe Marovsky has never failed to complete a City Finals course. Immovable object meet irresistible force.
Well, here's the force right here. Nice.
Marovsky had one of the fastest times in qualifying with a great moment as Joe looked down at his family.
A rare display of emotion out of Joe when he got to the warped wall with his wife holding his newborn baby daughter in her arms. Joe exploded onto the scene back in season 5, made it all the way to stage 3, has done it every year since.
Now at Rolling Thunder, qualifying Marovsky, one of only 9 competitors to complete it.
We know he's the weatherman, so he has to be in control of the Rolling Thunder here.
Joe Marovsky just annihilating this obstacle, reminiscent of his run on the rumbling dice.
Yeah, that time he broke the course, he broke the internet with that run, and it looks like he's on pace to do the same thing here, Matt.
Marovsky may be looking for the dismount here.
Oh, Matt, he's shaking his head. He's saying no, no mas.
Oh, that was a little close, but Marovsky doesn't even look fazed.
Well, he knows the real test comes after the warp wall. No problem.
Okay, he made the front part look easy, but now it gets real. The back half of this course has looked very tough.
Joe, keep moving, Joe!
All upper body tests, and it starts here with the salmon ladder. We're getting the crowd fired up as he jumps up.
Wow. Swimming upstream, Matt.
One obstacle down, 3 to go. Already into the flying shelf grab, got the first one.
Look at that grip.
Wow.
Are you sure he's a weatherman?
Well, the forecast for success continues. And as tough as this course is playing, just getting this far may get him into the top 15.
But he has 2 more obstacles if he wants to hit that buzzer.
My goodness, this stair hopper looks very dangerous.
Has to jump that bar down 4 steps and then up the other side. And as we've seen, that bar will slide on you.
Well, look at him trying to control the bar and trying to position it.
Oh, Matt, look, this it could slide off of him. He's
constantly
got
checking it. Oh, ooh, first transition up.
Watch out for that gap.
Inching it forward. Excellent control out of Marovsky.
And as he's trying to lachey.
And he's up.
Careful, nice. Get out of there. Get out of there.
And he's done it. Stairhopper. One more obstacle to go. He's finished every City Finals course he's ever run, Murawski trying to keep that streak alive, heading straight over to the invisible ladder. Can he be the first to hit the buzzer here in Philadelphia in the finals?
Well, last year in Pittsburgh, he had to fight for every inch on the invisible ladder.
Whoa, Joe, come on, Weatherman, you got this.
Well, he's gassed, he's already having to kick now. Those arms are done, Akbar.
He got up to 20 feet, come on. I need to see you come on it and bring it hard.
He's never failed to hit a buzzer.
Now, come on, breathe in, breathe out. Your wife, Stephanie, delivered Emily, and now you gotta deliver this one.
Can he do it?
You better hold on now.
Joe Murawski 5 feet away. Look at the fingers giving out. Oh! Can't hold on.
He got closer than anyone so far, but even the great Joe Murawski cannot finish this brutal Philly Finals course.
We have never had a city finals with zero finishers. We've got Jeff Britton in the crowd, but this course may be the first to go undefeated.
Matt, you may be right. If Joe Murawski gets to the invisible ladder and he doesn't have the strength to finish it, well, this may be the most challenging city finals we've ever had, and I don't know if anyone is gonna get through it tonight.
Let's go down to Christine for the Palm post-run interview.
Joe, you were so close there. Tell me what was going on.
I actually felt really good. I was maybe underestimating how much of my forearms I was gonna need. So I felt my biceps were great. I got on there, I was like, all right, this is good. I needed a little break, but all of a sudden I realized that my forearms were getting really tight and I needed to keep moving, no breaks. And fortunately, it was just too much.
All right, well, you're a new dad. Emily looks like she wants to go back to sleep, so we will let you do that. Congratulations, we'll see you back in Las Vegas, guys.
Thanks.
Well, this course is a real challenge, but Jeff Britton's done the impossible before. The first American Ninja Warrior will run later tonight. Plus, it's down to two women. Can Michelle Warkey,
great agility there,
or Jessie LeBrec,
hang time,
earn a ticket to the national finals? They're just ahead on American Ninja Warrior. Welcome back to Philadelphia and the City Finals round of American Ninja Warrior. Our coverage tonight is brought to you in part by our friends at Palm Wonderful. While we're away, a trio of athletes hope to punch their ticket to Las Vegas. The Philly physician, Dr. Richard Shoemaker, looks strong from the start. This doctor is shredded. And the 40-year-old doctor made it to the flying shelf grab before finally checking out. Oh, boom! Slam dunk into the water. Bus boy Mike Soria came out ready to take down the course.
Ooh, got body slam.
But the former high school wrestling champ was no match for Rolling Thunder.
Oh, he got pinned that time.
Maryland's Nick Kostreski crushed the first half of the course. Kostreski is rocking us like a hurricane, but the aerospace engineer couldn't figure out the flying shelf grab. Well, this course is just eating up ninjas as no one's hit the buzzer so far. But our next athlete has the talent to do it. It's Philadelphia's own Najee Richardson. He was once a top-level gymnast till his career was ended by injury. Now he's trying to become a top-level ninja. He gives credit to his family.
It felt incredible to get up on that warp wall and hit that buzzer.
And Philadelphia has a new hero!
Being able to look down and see everyone cheering, especially my family, it was awesome. I can't thank my parents enough for all of the sacrifices and the struggles to keep me involved in gymnastics, to see me have a better life.
We worked 2-3 jobs, long hours, but we knew we had to pull along to get him to where he needed to be.
The only way I can think of showing them how grateful I am is by leaving it all out there in the course and just show them that I am doing what they always knew I could do.
American Ninja Warrior thing, it's all over with. Najee gonna be the one. He gonna win this.
Najee's dad is watching on TV, but his mom, Dara, is here along with Najee's girlfriend and a big group of friends, all of them wearing those Phoenix t-shirts. Najee calls himself the Philly Phoenix because he's risen up from the injury that ended his gymnastics career.
Two-stepping. I see you two-stepping on the floating steps.
A little trouble with the rope there, not landing that dismount, and more struggles for Najee.
No more play on that rope.
He went out on the third obstacle last year, but put up one of the fastest times in qualifying.
5'7", 155.
Hold on tight.
Gets through. Now facing the paddle boards.
Ooh.
Good leap, nimble footwork out of Najee.
Was a high-level gymnast till he tore his right lateral meniscus three separate times. Had to quit gymnastics 4 years ago. Then discovered American Ninja Warrior.
And now needs to use those gymnastics skills right here at the wall drop.
And he sticks it.
Nice. I love the way he was smooth there on that transfer.
And he's through. The Phoenix flying through this course. Now heads for Rolling Thunder.
He completed this in qualifying, was very strong, and I expect to see that same strong performance here, but you cannot underestimate Rolling Thunder.
And fighting through this, those jolts, Najee Richardson, that dedication paying off.
This obstacle is such a beast. It just wears you down for the later obstacles. I think that's why we haven't had any finishers so far.
And you can see that those spokes lock it into place with every movement. You have to fight for every inch of terrain on the Rolling Thunder.
He is fighting for it, and he's moving it. Moving that one like a big dog.
Najee Richardson does it again. Now the 14 and a half foot warp wall.
Phoenix Bird, I see you, baby. You know what? I want to see this again. He just glides up the wall and catches big air. And look, his hands are another 2 feet above the rim. My goodness.
Now staring down the salmon ladder. It's the first time he's seen any of these back half obstacles. Got to get up four rungs.
Look at Najee. Look at hometown Philly boy.
Very strong.
Now he reaches the flying shelf grab. Can he be the first to finish this course?
Nice. Nice. This is a Philly boy. Nice.
Finish this, and he's assured a spot in Vegas.
Woo-hoo! I think he just realized it, Matt.
Only two other athletes have reached this point, so now he's guaranteed a spot in the top 15.
And you know what? Mama can pack her bags for Vegas, too.
Now the stair hopper. You have to be so careful on this. Easy to slide off the edge.
Well, Matt, he just has to have fun. This is the time and opportunity to show it. Oh!
Najee Richardson puts on the show for the hometown crowd, but his run ends at the very difficult stair hopper.
Well, the Phoenix showed he could fly at the warped wall. It's amazing how high he got. But at the stair hopper, he jumped down one level and the bar slipped down another. He couldn't hang on after that jolt.
And right now he's standing by with Christine.
Najee, what a difference a year makes for you. You looked incredible out there tonight. What do you think was the biggest difference in your performance from year to year?
Confidence. Last year I didn't have a lot of confidence. It was the first time I was getting into it. I didn't have a lot of training behind me. And this year I went really hard with my training and it paid off.
Najee, you have qualified for the finals in Las Vegas, Najee. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Guys, back to you.
Still no finishers, but maybe a superhero can save us. Captain NBC Jamie Ron is minutes away. Plus, we started with four history-making women. Now only two remain.
There it is!
And one of them is coming up.
Michelle Warking makes history
when American Ninja Warrior returns. Welcome back to American Ninja Warrior in Philadelphia. We're outside this city's historic Richmond Power Plant. With four women in our city finals for the first time ever, we knew it would be a historic night, but Akbar,
Tonight, we may be witnessing history of a different kind.
Well, that's right, Matt. We're 2/3 of the way through the field, and so far, nobody's figured out this course. Minutes ago, Brandon Pannell went down at the flying shelf grab. So did the fastest finisher in qualifying, Anthony DeFranco. Oh! And then veteran Mike Bernardo failed at the stair hopper.
No!
So far, 20 people have started the course, 0 have finished.
No!
Well, we've never had a city finals without at least one finisher, but maybe a superhero can save the day. Up next is Jamie Ron, the New Jersey gym owner who's better known as Captain NBC. This Cape Crusader has a new sidekick.
My girlfriend and I, we were dating for about a year, and our 1-year anniversary, I decided let's add one to the family, and we got a little puppy. Doogie is a Yorkshire Terrier. He's not a big one, I think he's a runt. Doogie's a great sidekick for Captain NBC. He is extremely loyal, and he's always ready to train.
Can I get 2 more? Boy.
Get him to a little balance obstacle if possible.
It ain't a bird, it ain't a plane, it's Jamie Ron!
Tonight, my trusty sidekick is definitely gonna be there. He's gonna be my support to make it all the way to Vegas.
And there's Doogie on the sidelines. Even he's got green hair, as do Jamie's girlfriend, Kim, and his parents. And don't forget the green-haired groupies that show up every time Jamie Ron runs. Ron timing the beeps, and he's off. Well, we talked about it. Not a ton of costume competitors anymore, but Jamie Ron, probably the best known and the best, most talented costume competitor.
And he's attacking right now.
Well, Jamie Ron's been competing since season 2 of American Ninja Warrior.
Ooh, that was so close. And that's why you can't underestimate any of these obstacles. Yes, you did it and completed it in qualifying, but doesn't guarantee you success in finals. You have to stay focused.
Right now, needs to focus on the trampoline 11 feet below him. Oh, grabs onto the log, but taking a few extra swings here. And he's fighting through those logs. Even a problem, this is a less than smooth run out of Captain NBC.
There have been some rough landing here. You know, I want to rewind back to the paddleboards. He went down just the right side. We've never seen anyone do that and make it across. Very risky for Jamie Ron.
Nonetheless, moving on to the fifth obstacle.
In qualifying, he was able to dominate Rolling Thunder. Let's see if he can put it all together again.
5'10", 160. He has been working on his speed and confidence, but he has always had strength. Ron was one of 9 competitors to complete the Philadelphia qualifying course. He is really moving this apparatus here.
He is rolling.
This obstacle knocked out 23 athletes in qualifying. He's taken out some good ones tonight.
Keep going, you're almost there, almost there. Keep going.
Ron is so powerful.
Woo. And look at this, he's just a superhero. He's taking it all the way to the end. He's securing that dismount.
And Ron has it. And a little smile there, throwing out the hearts to his girlfriend, his dog, and his parents. And he's got good speed to this point, but now the tough obstacles are ahead. And right up the warp wall.
This crowd wants to see someone hit the buzzer. We're running out of chances. Maybe Jamie Ron can be the guy.
Well, first it's the salmon ladder, and he's had one of these in his gym for years.
All right, here it is. Nice, nice movement.
And with that, he's reached the flying shelf grab. With only a few runners left, that may be good enough for Vegas, but you know he wants to hit the buzzer. Makes the first grab. And makes the second. Now just needs the dismount, and he's through. No one has finished this course. Will Jamie Ron be the first? But now the stair hopper, and only Joe Morovsky's been able to get through this one tonight.
There's 9 different levels here, Matt, and he's got to be consistent here. Smaller hops here. Oh, boy, he's taking big hops. Whoa! Oh,
it's a trap! He seemed in total control, but even an experienced veteran like Jamie Ron can't finish this brutal finals course in Philly.
Check this out again. Jamie Ron goes 1, 2, 3, 4, but on the fifth jump, he misses. And if you look closely, he didn't get that left side up enough. He banged it and came crashing down.
I wanted to go quick. I knew if I went slow, I would have gassed out. Figure hit as fast as I could. Almost worked.
This course looks unbeatable, but Jeff Britton, the first man to climb stage 4 in Vegas, is still waiting for his shot. We'll see him in a bit. Plus, our Fantastic Four are down to the final two. Michelle Warnke tries to do what she's never done before.
Oh! I got the eye of the tiger.
Welcome back to Philadelphia, our last stop before we head to Las Vegas next week for the national finals. To be a part of the ultimate fan community for American Ninja Warrior, join the conversation at the official SB Nation fan site at ANWNation.com. And this crowd's on its feet for another one of our history-making women. This is Michelle Warnke, the 31-year-old gym owner from Worthington, Ohio. She's the veteran among the four women running tonight. She's made it to this point, the city finals, 3 straight years, but she's never qualified for Vegas, and she wants it badly. Warnke's got a big group of friends here, including her vocal dad, Chris. Everyone will be watching, including her friends Jesse Graff and Jesse LeBrec. And Warnke wants to do what Jesse Graff already did, earn a spot in Vegas by making it into the top 15.
And that's some big-time pressure. She'll probably need to get to the flying shelf grab to make it.
Warnke's a trailblazer for women on the course and off. She's one of the first female ninja athletes to own a ninja gym. Opened up a movement lab gym along with the Wilcheskis in Ohio. And she's through the log grab. Now the paddle boards. Good balance. 5'4", 135. Warnke has a background as a distance runner. She went to University of the Cumberlands on a track scholarship.
Warnke's had trouble in the past on the trampoline. So she's got to be worried about this 11-foot drop.
You got it, Michelle. You got it. You got it.
Get this thing compressed here. Compressed. Yeah. Nice. See the way she compressed her legs there to absorb the power return from the trampoline.
And now trying to slide down on the log. Having a little trouble with the dismount here, getting that footing. Good push now. Locking it in.
Oh.
Fighting with the tongue. Oh,
look at her.
Michelle Warnke through, and now can she be the first woman to defeat the Rolling Thunder?
Matt, I've got a real good feeling about Michelle Warnke here on the Rolling Thunder.
Well, this is where she went out in qualifying. Rolling Thunder, just such an upper body test. It is a long way across this track.
This obstacle took out 23 competitors in qualifying, and it's taken out a few more tonight.
A comfortable pace here, Akbar, with that rock climber's grip.
Yeah, watch out for that drop. Good, good. Okay, good. She absorbed it. Now, look, Matt, this is going to take a lot of strength on the inside here.
And she's shaking it out. How much does she have left in that tank?
Come on, girl.
Warnke continuing to fight through it. She's moving fighting. That wheel. Now, will she go for the dismount? Turn around here.
No, she's got to get a little bit more. She needs to move that thing about 20 more inches here on that rail and then turn around.
And Warnke continuing to fight. Tremendous upper body strength. Tremendous result.
She could care less if she's on E. Turn around, though, Michelle. Turn around and see your destiny.
Just a few feet from safety.
Oh, she is disappointed. Look at that. Oh.
Michelle Warnke comes up just short on Rolling Thunder.
Well, she was only a couple of feet away from the landing area, but she was losing her strength and looking for an exit. And watch her fingers. They just peel right off the wheel.
And she's standing by with Christine.
Michelle, I know that this is very disappointing for you. You went out, I think, on the exact same spot that you went in qualifying on the Rolling Thunder. Yeah. What about it is so difficult?
Well, it's really pumpy, it's heavy. I was almost there and I was like, do I swing? Do I try to keep going? And I was losing strength. Now I gotta, I gotta beat it.
I know you can do it, Michelle. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Christine. But we think about it, 4 women in the city finals tonight. That would have been unimaginable just a few years ago. And we still have one more to go. The former track star Jessie Lebrecq is the last hope for the Fantastic Four. Her run's just minutes away. Plus, Jeff Britton's on a roll.
Yes!
After climbing stage 4 in Vegas and finishing qualifying in Philly, he's hit 7 straight buzzers.
No problem!
Can he possibly make it 8 in a row?
It's gonna be a battle.
We'll find out when American Ninja Warrior returns. Welcome back to Philadelphia and the city finals of American Ninja Warrior. Up next, another one of our familiar veterans. This is Chris Wilczewski, the popular gym owner from nearby Mount Laurel, New Jersey. And he has an unusual streak going. He only has success every other year. In season 4, he made it to stage 2 in Vegas. In season 5, he fell in qualifying. In season 6, he made it back to stage 2. But in season 7, he once again fell in qualifying. Oh no!
Well, you know what that means, Matt. He's due. This is an on year for him.
And as you can see, Chris is sporting pink hair and pink pants. That's to honor the mom of fellow ninja Henry Ferrarin, who's battling breast cancer. Here's Henry, along with Chris's brother, Brian.
And he looks like he's in better shape, too. I mean, if you think about it, it just looks like he's more ripped, more toned.
Went out on a balance obstacle last year, but gets through the paddleboards this year. It's Wilczewski's parents there. They're here along with many other athletes he's helped train. His gym, the Movement Lab, one of the first ninja training facilities in the country.
Keep moving, Chris.
All right, hurry, but don't rush. Be careful on the trampoline.
Makes the grab. Now sliding down to the bottom where he can generate a little more swing. And he hooks the leg. And he's getting through. And now the obstacle that took him out in qualifying, Rolling Thunder. Still no finishers on this city finals course in Philly.
And Matt, this is one of the big reasons why. This obstacle right here, Rolling Thunder, just wears down your upper body. Even if you get through, you don't have a lot of juice left for the other obstacles.
Wilczewski making good progress. Wilczewski shockingly fell on the third obstacle last year in Pittsburgh. Looking to bounce back this year.
Hey, Matt, this is what I love. Your failure doesn't mean that you're gonna have a same repeat. You learn from your failure and you get results. And that's what I'm seeing here from Chris Wilczewski, results.
And Wilczewski going for the dismount. And he's coming in.
Yes!
He looks focused, Akbar. Wilczewski looks focused.
Well, that's the type of focus you need.
And the warp wall, not even a challenge for this man who's been competing since back in season 2. He's made it as far as stage 2 in Vegas. And maybe we're beginning to see how great a ninja Chris Wilczewski can truly be.
Well, he owns a gym. He should be ready for the salmon ladder. I want to see that dog come out of it. Look at him.
Just flies to the top rung. Now ready for the flying shelf grab.
Well, the click clack was good. Now he's got to fly and be smooth here on the transition. Well, we've seen people now kind of go out wide. You got to go narrow here on the flying shelf grab. Good. Boy, look at him harnessing that aggression here. A positive effort.
And Chris Wilczewski has electrified this crowd. And now the stair hopper, which has been almost unbeatable.
Well, Matt, the stair hopper is like a horizontal salmon ladder here.
Look at this, he's making it look easy.
Whoa!
Did you see that jump?
Look at him, he's flying right through it.
My goodness, Wilczewski on fire. No one's made it through like this. And Wilczewski dominates.
Oh my God.
And look at him. This course is brutal, but he's smiling to the camera and not even slowing down.
He should take a breath, Matt. There's no need to rush at this point.
But here goes Wilczewski, 30 feet to the top. Will he be the first to complete this grueling Philadelphia City Finals course?
Well, Matt, he may not have anything left in the fifth minute, but I know he's got heart, and he's got a lot of blood pumping through his heart right now to get to the top here.
He is bouncing around trying anything, but this course in Philly just wears you out. Can anyone finish it?
And this 10th obstacle here, you got to earn it. And he is making it all the way. Putting a lot of stress here on the shoulder and the joint. The AC joint, everything is stressed out here.
Well, he's really using his entire body range.
He can get 25 feet out the fall.
Chris Wilczewski comes up just a few feet short on the invisible ladder, but one of the best runs we've ever seen from this veteran.
First, look at the stair hopper. Others have struggled here, but he jumps across three steps with ease. And then at the invisible ladder, you could see his arms were done on those last few feet and the grip gave out.
And right now, Chris is standing by with Christine.
Chris, you were just inches away from getting to the top and hitting that button. How pumped out were you?
It was one of the hardest courses I've ever done. That invisible ladder is no joke. Everything before it was incredibly difficult. I was so close. I really wanted it.
Last season did not go as you wanted. How great does redemption feel this year?
Oh, it feels so good to come back and kick butt in my hometown city. It really felt amazing.
Well, you kicked butt so much that I can officially tell you that you are going to Las Vegas. We're going to see you in the National.
Yes!
Matt Knockbar, back to you.
No one has hit the buzzer.
Wow.
We've never had a city finals course pitch a shutout against our talent.
Well, I knew Philadelphia was tough, but I didn't know it was that tough.
But it's not over yet. Jeff Britton's still going to take his shot at the course. And so does our final female competitor, and they don't call her Flex for nothing. Jessie LeBrec runs when we come back on American Ninja Warrior. Welcome back to the Philadelphia City Finals of American Ninja Warrior. While we await, two more athletes tried to punch their ticket to the National Finals. John Alexis Jr., a.k.a. the Giant, looked like he might crush this course.
A little samurai sword action.
But even at 6'6", he came up short at the stair hopper. But that was good enough for some good news.
You are going to Las Vegas.
Despite an injured shoulder, crowd favorite, Ryan Stratus battled his way to the back half.
Hold that!
Ryan Stratus!
That's a bad dude right there!
The eight-time veteran couldn't figure out the stair hopper.
Oh! Look at his face. He's saying, oh, shut!
But he, too, is going to Vegas. Up next, our final female competitor of the night. And from the four women who started this night, we are down to just Jessie LeBrec, better known as Flex LeBrec. She impressed us in qualifying with her run on the course and her work off of it. She's the caregiver for a young girl with cerebral palsy named Emmeline, who's back on the sidelines tonight.
Nice, look at,
wow!
That was so smooth!
And Emmeline is loving it.
I was super excited that Em could be there to watch me compete in the Philadelphia qualifier.
She's taking down each obstacle right now.
When I compete, I usually have tunnel vision, but I was just about to go up and do an obstacle, and I heard her kind of yell to me. We made eye contact, and she started laughing, and it made me feel better, kind of calmed me down, and then I went into the next obstacle.
What obstacle do you want to see me make it to?
I can't wait to see you on the salmon ladder.
Is it because I fall on it all the time?
It's really been wonderful to see how Jessie and Emmeline have developed an amazing relationship. They love each other. They're best friends.
A little rain doesn't bother us, right, Em?
Jessie is just a loving gift in our lives.
I'm really excited that Emmeline will be there to support me in finals. And it's a big trip for her. I don't want to disappoint her.
So when I hit the buzzer, Emmeline's going to be very excited.
She's just happy that my dreams are coming true.
And there's Emmeline ready to cheer along with Jesse's boyfriend and her family. Plus, she's got a huge cheering section that includes the other women who ran tonight in Philly. The ninja community always so supportive.
Well, Matt, she's a stud athlete. You know, she was a track star at the University of Maine, still holds 11 school records. How about that?
She ran hurdles, did the high jump. She even competed in the heptathlon. And she just blew us away with her power in qualifying.
And those heptathletes, now, let me tell you, they are powerful, they are strong, and they definitely have strength endurance. That's what's needed here on American Ninja Warrior.
5'7", 145. She got the nickname Flex for those muscles. Now gonna use those track skills here on the paddle boards. Didn't stumble, but she's through. Right up into the wall drop. This obstacle has taken out some good ones tonight, including her friend Rachel Goldstein.
It's 11 feet down, and trampolines are always tricky.
Wow. Great technique there. Locked right onto the log. Seeming to control it now. This dismount, though, has been problematic for a lot of competitors, especially in qualifying.
Ooh, Matt, she's losing purchase here.
Woo-hoo-hoo. And trying to get down low on the log to make it easier.
She's a fighter,
the pendulum
she's
action.
A fighter. She's a fighter, LeBron.
Now moving on to Rolling Thunder. And I love how she's visualizing her moves. And a little look over to Emmeline, and look at Emmeline's smile.
Come on, Jesse. Jesse owned this.
This is the obstacle that took her out in qualifying. In fact, no woman has made it past it. Michelle Warnke did come close. Oh, look at those back muscles, Akbar.
Ooh, ooh. Oh, watch out for your nose.
145, and she is dominating this.
So far, so good. This first part of the track here, Matt, she's really starting to move this thing. The same thing that she was rehearsing prior to getting on the Rolling Thunder, you see her doing it now. Don't stall out.
But those arms are starting to straighten out now, Akbar. That's fatigue setting in.
I think she's starting to plan her dismount here.
Switch it to the side there. You can see the plexiglass blocking the grip placement. So close.
More revolution. Come on. Create a revolution here.
No woman has ever completed this obstacle.
Come on, girl. Come on. A couple more revolutions and you're there.
And Emmeline willing her forward.
Oh.
Right there. She's going for the dismount.
She's going for it. She's going for it.
Can the grip hold out? Yes. Yes. And
the revolution will be telephoned.
The crowd on their feet for Flex LeBron.
She's damn near in tears right now.
Well, only two women have gotten up this new warped wall, Megan Martin and Jesse Graff. Can Jesse LeBrecq continue this rookie campaign? And look at Emmeline, just a few feet away.
Come on, Jesse.
Yes!
Nice!
Not even close! Flex LeBrecq crushes her.
I see you, Flex.
Well, this is a big moment. She's now just the fifth woman ever to get up the warped wall in American Ninja Warrior competition. And now she's got a chance to earn a ticket to next week's national finals, something only Jesse Graff and Megan Martin have done this year. Well, Em said she wanted to see Flex on the salmon ladder. Here it is. Only a handful of women have ever reached this point. Boom!
Wow! That's an elite athlete. I see you, girl.
She just crushed the salmon ladder. And now she's reached the flying shelf grab.
Matt, that's my home girl right there. That's my home girl right there.
No woman ever completed the shelf grab.
I see you. Yes.
Who is this?
I'll tell you right now. That girl is a LeBrecq house.
Wow.
She is a LeBrecq house.
That's my home girl. She's now earned a trip to Vegas. She joins Jesse Graff and Megan Martin for this season. But LeBrecq, the first woman ever to do it as a rookie.
Okay, Matt, we've had no finishers tonight. Can a woman be our first?
Well, first, she's got to get past the stair hopper.
I swear to you, Matt, If she gets past this stair hopper, I'm going to run out of this booth right here. It's amazing.
Well, this obstacle has been a killer. Only two competitors have gotten past it. Can LeBrec keep this run alive?
Every move has to be perfect. Come on, girl. Come on, move it.
Jamie Ron, like Mike Bernardo, Ryan Stratus couldn't do it.
Now watch out here. There is a gap. We saw the gap.
Oh! Well, even Flex LeBrec has her limits, but the entire crowd in Philadelphia on their feet for the new sensation.
Jesse LeBrec has joined the club with the elite athletes.
Well, that's got to be our Bob Wonderful, crazy healthy run of the night. Jesse LeBrec just hit a lot of milestones. She became the fifth woman to scale the warp wall on American Ninja Warrior. And when she finished the flying shove grab, she became the third woman this season to earn a trip to Vegas and the first to do it as a rookie.
Right now, she's standing by with Christy.
Jesse, amazing job up there. I can absolutely see why people call you Flex LeBrec. Explain to me what you were thinking as you were up there on a brand new obstacle as a rookie.
I was thinking, my arms are really hurting, but everyone is cheering so loud. I didn't want to let anyone down, and I wanted to make it to the rings, but it's okay. I'm really proud of myself, and I had a really good time.
Emmeline here was also cheering for you big time. How much does it really mean to have her here supporting you?
I couldn't see her at one point, and I could hear her, and I made sure I could make eye contact, and I was like, I got it. It's time for me to go. So it was big.
Well, Jesse, you are not done yet. We need you to represent the women in Las Vegas. You made it far enough, fast enough. You're going to the national finals. Congratulations. We're going to let you guys celebrate. Nine up far back to you.
Well, it'll be tough to top that. But hey, we still need a finisher tonight. Can the great Jeff Britton be the one to break through? He's our last chance. And his run's next on American Ninja Warrior. Welcome back to the Philadelphia City Finals.
Well, how fitting is this? History is all over Philadelphia. At this point, no one has completed this City Finals course. And I thought, we have never had a City Finals with zero finishes.
But if anyone can save the day, it's our final competitor, Maryland cameraman Jeff Britton. Not only was he the first to climb stage four in Las Vegas, but perhaps more impressive is that he's finished the last seven courses he started. An unbelievable streak of hitting seven straight buzzers, six last season, and one a few weeks ago in qualifying.
Wow!
In season seven, I was successful in accomplishing my goal of hitting every single buzzer, something no one else has ever done. A lot of people have asked me what kind of pressure I'm feeling going into the season, and it's really simple. I don't have as much pressure as I had last year. I accomplished my goal. Now it's all fun.
Oh, that was close.
The qualifying course was really hard. Seven buzzers was an amazing feeling.
There you go, baby. Yes, you can.
I don't know what it's gonna take to finish this finals course, but it's gonna be superhuman. It would be phenomenal to hit eight buzzers in a row. Is that possible? Stay tuned.
There's Jeff's wife, Jessica. She's gonna be holding her breath.
You got it, Jeff!
And every ninja in the house is on their feet for this. Britton's hit seven buzzers in a row, but no one's finished the course tonight, so one streak must end. Of course, Britton's been a pioneer before as the first ever to climb stage four in Vegas.
And you know, Jeff Britton missed out on $1 million by 3 seconds last year. He knows pressure-filled runs, but this course in Philly is brutal.
And this course lines up well for his talent. But the paddleboards can be dangerous.
Nice, nice, nice.
And he's through.
Great.
Now the wall drop. And with the trampoline, this can be tricky as well.
Well, we know with Britton's Popeye forearms, climbing up won't be a problem here.
And now the 11-foot drop. And he nails it right through. Jessica Britton always seems more nervous than Jeff, and this crowd is hanging on every move as he now faces off with Rolling Thunder.
We talked about the immovable object and the irresistible force, a course that no one has beaten. Took out Joe Morovsky, the man who had the perfect record, and now Jeff Britton,
a guy who's hit seven straight buzzers trying to make it eight. Whoa!
He almost slipped off with them Popeye arms saved him. Well, who needs spinach when you got them forearms?
His spinach is this course. He loves American Ninja Warrior. And look at Jeff, how locked in those arms are, vice grips.
Matt, this is inches from being over. Watch Britton's left hand. He just misses the wheel completely and nearly came off.
Now the warped wall. And he's saying his arms are pumped out. Rolling Thunder will wear you out. But right up the warped wall.
You know what, this crowd is starving to see a finisher, and it's gonna come down to these final four obstacles.
This Philly course has seemed unbeatable. Can Jeff Britton do it?
Right, Jeff.
First up the salmon ladder.
I think the whole world wants him to get a shot at getting that $1 million that he lost.
And he's through. Now the flying shelf grab. Makes the first one, now 8 feet to the next ledge. He's got it.
Oh, Shana, he made that look easy.
Just needs the dismount. 2 more obstacles to go, and I don't know if his wife Jessica can handle it. This crowd on their feet as he takes on the stair hopper. This obstacle is a beast. Only Morovsky and Wilczewski have made it past. Here we go.
Oh, okay, he's down the cover now. He's shuffling it through here. Now watch out for the gap.
Oh! Jeff Britton! And for the first time ever, no one has completed a city finals course. Jeff Britton will move on to Vegas, but his streak of 7 straight buzzards is over.
We all fall, huh?
And Jessica Britton's gonna join him.
Oh, you got that.
He didn't finish, but still a great run for Jeff Britton.
Well, watch Britton again. As he jumps down the steps, he's looking side to side, being so careful. But on the last step, he just edges the bar too close to the end, and boom, there's nothing to stop it from sliding off.
Let's go down to Christine for the Palm post-run interview.
Jeff, you're the first American Ninja Warrior. That stair hopper is so difficult for people tonight. Can you tell me why?
I don't know why. I still don't even know why I fell, but I sure did.
Why do you think this course was so difficult?
Because it's really hard. The qualifying felt like a stage 3 course to me. We were exhausted.
We had to make things a little bit harder after what you did last year.
Thanks. I'm really scared to go to Vegas now.
Well, that is where you're going. We're going to see you back in the national finals. Go get dry. Yeah!
So for the first time, no finishers on our leaderboard. Chris Wilczewski and Joel Morovsky made it the farthest, getting to the invisible ladder. Jeff Britton's run left him in the 8th spot. But how about Jessie Lebrecht? She became the 3rd woman this year to qualify for the national finals. All these athletes now move on, including 42-year-old Carl Fantuzzo, who held on to the final spot. Next week, it's what we've been building to all season long, the national finals in Las Vegas. Only the top competitors remain, and they'll be facing some brand new obstacles as they try to conquer all 4 stages of Mount Midoriyama with $1 million at stake. You don't want to miss it. For Akbar Bajabia Mila and Christine Leahy, I'm Matt Eisman. We'll see you next time on American Ninja Warrior.
In the history of Ninja Warrior, no woman has finished a course in the finals.
No quitting that woman.
Next Monday.
Finishing would help show women you can do so much more than you think you can. I want to finish stage 1 tonight.
Can you feel history in the making here?
Will she become the first and inspire a nation?
She's gonna
Emmy-nominated American Ninja Warrior, all new next Monday on NBC. And all new Running Wild with Bear Grylls starts right now on NBC.